Hello everyone, let's get started with our next tutorial in which I'll be talking about creating schema. So let me connect to the HANA Studio. So this is the icon for HANA Studio that I have on my desktop. Let me double click on this icon and HANA Studio is starting. So this is the perspective that we see when it is connected to the system. Okay, so what we need to do is we need to make sure that we are in the modular perspective. Here it shows that this is a modular perspective. What we can do is just to validate, just make sure that everything is closed, go to window and click on open perspective and select modular. Okay, so this ensures that we are in the modular perspective. Now let's click on the system. This is the HANA database that we are working on. And here you can see this is catalog, you have content there. So I'll go into the catalog folder. So in catalog you have the authorization, you have public synonyms, and these are the different schemas that is created. So in today's topic, what we'll do is we will be creating a schema. So to create a schema, just right click on the catalog folder and click on SQL editor. Okay, so the editor has been opened. Now to create a schema, just we need to type create schema and the schema name. So let me type it, create schema. So let's name it as sit test 1. Okay, so this is the name of the schema that I am going to create. So just to create it, you can see the green arrow button to execute this particular SQL statement. So let me execute this, and at the bottom you can see that the message appears that statement create schema successfully executed. So here we are not seeing it. So to see that, we need to refresh this particular screen. Okay, now you can look for this schema, which is test 1. So this schema has been created. Now you can see there are no tables there, no views there. Okay, because we have just created an empty schema. So this schema is created under the user ID as system. So if we don't specify who is going to own this particular schema, it gets created under the default user ID, which is system. Okay, so next thing what we'll see how to drop a schema. So to drop a schema, the command is drop schema and the schema name. So let's execute this particular command with the green arrow over here. We'll get the message at the bottom that this drop schema has been executed successfully. To validate, here you can see this is still there, but we need to refresh this particular screen. So just come on the catalog folder, click on refresh. Okay, on refreshing you can see this particular schema is no more there. So this is how we will be dropping a schema if we don't need that schema anymore in the system. So schema is basically we are organizing all our development structure, all our tables, procedures in one particular schema. So that is a broader organization of tables and the work that is done normally for a particular project. Okay, so next thing is, here we saw that this schema gets created the moment you try to create it gets created in a default schema, which is system. So how we can ensure that it doesn't get created in system? So for that, what we'll do is we'll create, say we have a test user over here. So we will create this under the ownership of the user test. So to do that, what we'll do is we'll create this schema and we'll just mention that this scheme create schema test 1, and we need to specify the ownership. So to specify the ownership, we'll just mention that this schema is owned by test 1. Okay, so if I execute this here, the statement is create schema, the name of the schema, and the ownership, which is this particular user, which is test 1. Okay, let's execute this by pressing this green arrow button over here, and here we get the message this user is no more there. So the username is test, so we'll create it under test Okay, you get the message that this has been executed successfully. The schema has been created. Okay, let's see this particular schema. Let me try to refresh this. Okay, let's see. Do we see this over here? No. This is under system. So what we need to do is we need to log in as that particular user. So let's create another user. Let's log in with that particular user and we will see the schema there. So let me go to that particular user, and this is the user that we have. This is the test user. So what I'll do is I will reset the password, define the password for that user. Okay, so I have set the password. So let me change the password for this user test. Okay, it says that we need to have a particular combination. So let me give the password as welcome1. Okay, so let me execute this to change the password. Okay, it says that you cannot reuse the password. So let me give another password for this. Okay, let me execute this. Okay, now the password has been changed. Now what I am going to do is I am going to log in this with another user, which is test user. So I'll type this user here, and the password that I just created is welcome2. So let me execute this. And the moment it is connected with a successful password, it will ask for a change of password. So let me change the password for it. Okay, so the first time you log in, you will be requested for change in password. Here you can see there is another entry which is created, HN3 test. So this is with the test user. Okay, now let's see whether our schema is here. So we have created schema called test1. We can see this particular schema has been created here. Okay, so we have not defined any tables or anything in that particular schema, so this is an empty schema. Okay, and we have just seen that how to connect using that particular schema and go to that particular schema, and all the work you are doing will be on this particular schema itself. Okay, thanks everyone. That's what I wanted to cover in this particular session, which was how to create a schema in SAP HANA using HANA Studio. Thanks everyone.